I've just been making some pulleys for some hand generators, and I thought I'd show you how I balance them so that they run nice and true and smooth. One thing to do is, instead of having a broomstick going through a circular hole, it's good to make a square hole to put that through so that it doesn't slip on the shaft. Now on the broomstick end, I'm going to mark more or less the four quadrants so that I know where the four corners of my broom handle are. Mark them on the sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, so that I can, and also mark it around. Then I'm going to cut the four sides. Then I'm going to cut down the four sides to get my square. So it finishes like this. Now, having marked out a board and a square, finding the center, I'm going to put my square pole on there and mark that. And with a square, transfer that square to the other side of the board. So it's on both sides, and we know it's going to line up when it's cut. So with the chisel on the flat edge outwards, I'm going to go down perpendicular to start with, and then come back on an angle, nibbling backwards, then turn it around, go down perpendicular, and then this way, and then nibble back that way, down to halfway, flip the board over, and come from the other side. There we have it, and the pole can now slide into there, and there we have it. Cut that one off. Cut the pole off to the length that you have decided. Then I'll find the center of both sides of that pole, make a little hole, and with a compass, draw a circle around to know where to cut the corners off. Then, as with other pulleys, I just keep cutting corners and corners until I get a rough circle. Then, of course, is the process with a hacksaw blade, just to take the tips off those little bits and make it a little bit rounder. Then go through the process of turning it into a pulley. Now, if I have done this line, this cut around here, evenly right around the hob hole, it should just click in there and then spin relatively well so far, and then we just need minor adjustments from here. And just to make sure it's not going to move on me there, any slack that's there I can glue and wedge, a very fine wedge or two in there, just to make sure it's now going to be firm. And cut that off. Now, I've made an apparatus just like I did for doorknob making, just a little bit higher to suit. Going to undo that, pop that one out, pop that one back in, and this is made more or less the width I want. And now I have this. Thank you. So there we have it, spinning sufficiently balanced for what we want it for anyway.